Hey there, this is Cole, back for another stream session of Deadly Premonition. We are in the final lap here, folks. We just fought and killed the Raincoat Killer 1, Sheriff George Woodman. And now we are trying to find Emily, who... Well, we really don't know where she's at. But we're going to try and get there anyway. And avoid the gigantic dogs, if at all possible. In our invincible car. We're going to have to head to the clock
Zach,
tower.
I'm getting a really bad feeling about all this. I truly believe George was the murderer that we were after. But killing him, of course, does not solve all the murders related to the Red Seeds. I do not know if what Harry said is true at all. The answer to the mystery of those Red Seeds is here in this town. I'm sure of that. I failed as an FBI agent. I left Emily alone as I slept through an entire day. Zach, I need you to pray with me. Pray that things have not gone too far.
Hey there, all we can do is Theodore go to the location Fox, written in Kaysen's letter. Oh shit, it's a dog. Fuck me. Okay. We've got coffee and quests. We've got your monster back. We've got the usual folks. Love this crazy, ominous jazz that's happening underneath this. Draw distance. You got it? Entire town has gone crazy in the middle of the day. It's 4 p.m. Oh. Right on top of me. This is gonna be my, my last opportunity to do a sick drift. So let's try it. No, wait, I think I can go up and around. The distance, fuck. Nothing bad can happen to me in this car. Oh. My right blinker is on. Let me switch to the left. There we are. Am I seriously going entirely the wrong way? Right, it's time for a sick drift. Yeah! The dog helped me. I didn't turn entirely around. Fuck yes. Okay, we're about a mile away. Hey there, Account 404. What up? Welcome.
Hey
We're not going to the clock tower. We are going to George's house. I thought I was. Come on, doggo. Let me in the circle. There we are. This is
George's house.
You didn't know that was where you were going? So, we'll remember from a previous side quest, this is where his mom was. He was taking care of her. She was sick. The windows are all boarded up. We've never been able to look inside his house. And he has no furniture. Nothing. It's like Raiden from Metal Gear Solid 2.
This is most strange, Zack. I thought this story was all over. But it looks like there's something else before we get to see the ending.
No posters on his walls. I'm gonna save. The universal shorthand for crazy owns mannequins. This section is actually pretty cool. Oh shit. It's a discount bulk bag of tarps here in Greenvale Tech. Whoa. Walls of Crazy about Emily.
Zack, it looks like George really had a thing for Emily.
Oh, there's his mom. She'll give me answers. Ms. Woodman? Miss Woodman? Skin looks a little dry, Miss Woodman.
Meeting the mother is always a bad experience after killing the son.
That sound cute.
Zach, look. It wasn't a reversed peace mark.
FK in the coffee. Looks like two trees, but what else does it mean?
Casein.
Forest?
Forest.
Casein.
Casein. He's the one. Emily.
Ruh-roh.
Come to the theater. There the final curtain shall rise. So the guy who is constantly carrying around a potted sapling of the red tree is somehow associated with the red tree. Let's take a look at what they want us to know.
Previously during the investigation.
Welcome to Greenvale. Agent Francis York Morgan.
You're out of your mind. The goddess won't smile for you anymore, George.
Emily. Which room is Emily in?
That wasn't a reversed peace mark.
Red tree.
Zach, I need you to pray with me. Pray that things have not gone too far.
And now for something very different. Let's look at where the raincoat killer myth came from. That fateful night when the man spread the purple military gas and made everybody go crazy.
There! Over there! Ah.
As Harry's dad right now. Look up there in the health bar. R killer. Monster says, "You're a real monster, Cole. Hashtag think about it." Huh. How do I get up there? Struggling right instead of left. I remember being very frustrated by this all the past times I've played it because, God, they don't do a very good job of signaling where you're supposed to go aside from giving you the mark and then blocking off the most obvious paths to get up there. So yeah, this is 1956. We remember getting some exposition from Harry, the eccentric millionaire, that he went out one night frustrated with his father, and it started raining, and he went up to the clock tower, where we're headed now, and he saw people from the military using devices to disseminate this noxious purple gas that made everybody go crazy and kill each other. And when Harry was wandering through the streets watching the carnage, he saw his father in a red raincoat with an axe killing some people. Hey, Atomic Ninja 101. That was the last thing he remembered. I need to get up to this clock tower before the 13th bell. Let's hope I have not wasted too much time. Oh, and Jeremy's here. What up? Oh, and you're getting to hear the strange sixth and seventh verses of Amazing Grace, which you never really hear. Yeah, I'm happy you're all able to join me, join all of us. For the conclusion of this game, because it's real nuts. There we go. Why are there so many pickaxes in this lumber town? I don't have time to deal with you. That's just Lieutenant Kaysen with his standard army issue red sapling. It's all zombie versions of my favorite, beloved townspeople.
Daddy, Mommy, and Grandpa.
Everyone's acting strange.
It's okay.
And there they go, too.
Zach, the situation has gone way out of control. We need to get inside the theater.
I heard somebody tweet me. All right.
Zach, they're currently being controlled by an unknown force. Let's try not to hurt them if we can.
What is that, Jeremy? Says, when does the DJ yell mustard on the beat? That's how I know it's a remix. Referring again to the extra verses to Amazing Grace. Let's shave here just cuz I don't want to be scraggly for the final act. How are my stats doing? Little hungry. That can't be. Let's eat some pocket ham. Yeah, there we go. And drink some of this coffee from the bladder that I keep on the inside of my thigh. Let's also see here. Can I change out? Or is this suit still going to be under... Yeah, it's still... Yeah, I think I'll be fine. I might eat those words, but... Let's also grab some first aid. Womp. Let's take that. Oh wait, I need to take the Thomas biscuit. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, those Thomas biscuits recover a lot of life. Which is something that you need when you're going into the final boss fights.
Open this door. There is no turning back. You still want to enter? Very well, then. Off you go, Mr. York.
So says Mr. Stewart. Hey, Belmont, you're here for the climax.
And finally you arrive, York.
George is dead.
You've got nowhere left to run. George! All right, George! He was a funny one.
I gave him a toy locket, and he was so impressed,
so moved.
But he wasn't very intelligent. He was born in this town, you see, and it took him too long to discover the Red Sea. Binding down people's rules is a sign of small-mindedness, and that was what George represented in life.
I'm taking Emily.
Oh, but I can't allow that now, can I? York, you left her to me, in my care, remember? I told you to come with us, didn't I?
You must remember that.
But you didn't come. You chose your job over the woman that you love.
Casey! This chit-chat is over.
Over? Indeed it is. My fun with Emily ended just a moment ago. It was a fantastic moment. Like eating a full-course dinner that ends with the ultimate dessert. I fed her a fake story about my past, and she took in every word.
Cut out your nonsense. I told you, no more talk.
There you go, York. That's right. Feel the hate boiling from the bottom of your stomach. That's what makes little men create such great and amazing history. Just like tiny ants that make giant anthills. You know, I just had dessert and yet I'm already hungry again. No wonder why I keep failing at keeping a diet.
Kaysen, stop! The next one will pierce you between your eyes.
York!
Emily, it's me. I'm here. Don't worry. Everything will be fine now.
York? Is that you? God. York. I...
Emily, no! That isn't me!
York. York.
Emily! It's okay, Emily. Hurry, come over here. We need to get you to the hospital.
I can't. I can't go to you. I've been soiled.
No, that's not true. You have a heart that can't be soiled. No matter what happens to your body, you are still yourself.
York,
Oh, didn't I tell you? Getting these saplings to sprout requires a certain technique. What do you think? Artistic, isn't it? It's like a surrealistic painting.
Yeah, I don't have any jokes about that. That's legitimately horrifying.
York, shoot me.
Emily?
should I do?
There are a couple different ways this can shake out.
I'm sorry, my darling.
Let her go! Remove that sapling from her body, Kaysen.
Xander, it's too late. Once it's like this, I can't do anything to stop it.
Please, darling, shoot me. I'd rather die. If you love me, let me die.
And we've seen what happens. We've seen what happens with George's mom, who the same thing happened to. The tree takes life from its host. We saw that in the graveyard.
At times, we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love. Yet, I couldn't do it. However, you can. When the time comes and you have to make that decision, make the right one.
Okay, Zach? Zach.
That's not my name.
Morgan. Francis. Zach Morgan. Francis. Zach Morgan.
I saw you, Zach.
There's the scar.
Hey, Zach! It's okay. I'm here. I'm with you. I'll be with you always. We can get through this together. Who are you?
My name is York. Me and you will always be together.
Okay, Zach, I'm you, and you are me. Now, give me your hand.
And there we go. That's what he's always looked like.
I remember. I traded places with York. York, the other me. My other personality.
Zach! Please! Please shoot! Kill me!
York was there to protect Zach.
York, what should I do? Tell me what to do, York. Zach, you have to decide for yourself what you must do. I'll be with you no matter what you decide. Don't worry.
There's only one answer. That's what we've seen. When it's time, you have to remove things from the world. Even if it means killing someone you love.
There are some things in this world that must be extracted. no matter what. Even if that means losing someone that you love.
And the scar that people were remarking about, well, it was bigger than we saw.
I can't do it. I can't kill Emily.
I'm sorry, Zach.
Stop. Emily!
Ladies and gentlemen, and now the grand finale.
Emily, what have you done?
Zach, I wasn't used as soil at all.
You're beautiful. Most beautiful person I've ever seen.
Thank you, Zach. I wanted to be with you.
The goddesses of the forest.
Emily, no. You aren't supposed to go over there. That's not the way. Come back, Emily.
York and Zach. Finally, I understand. You two really are best friends. I'm a little jealous.
This actually makes me kind of sad.
Hey, stand up, Zach. It's up to you now.
Emily, I finally got to meet you face to face. But you had to go with York, didn't you? He always gets the girl.
He's a good guy. You see that too, right? He kept talking to me. And ended up pulling me back out of that room.
The red room where we saw a bunch of stuff happen.
I'm sure he'll make you very happy.
Here we go. Oh, wow, that is loud. That is real loud. Let me lower that volume for you real quick. Oh, man. Now let's go for it. Oh, you keep putting me with that shitty Ah, that shitty handgun.
Zach, go back to the room.
Did he just fart at me? I forgot about that.
You should have just stayed in there, Zach. Zach, go back to the room.
Yeah, he is totally farting at me. I forgot about that. Which is funny because you would think that is not the kind of thing that that I would forget about.
You fool.
Yeah, Kaysen is a servant of the Red Tree. In a way, he is a salesman, spreading those around.
What was that, Zach?
Oh shit.
What was that, Zach?
Zach has a lot of gun skills for being locked in a psychic prison for 30 years. Big boy. Gonna shoot you right in the dick. More cinematics. I think one more boss fight before we get to the final one.
Humans are so foolish,
so foolish. There's nothing to compare. With one whiff of that gas I made from the seeds, they'd happily kill each other. Even their neighbors, even the ones they love. Not much compared to the full effects of the seeds themselves, but I still got a really good laugh out of it. Anyway, I think we've had enough fun for today. And I really don't like having to exercise.
Now for another boss fight. Again, kind of with some Goku-esque features. It's like a Goku pineapple.
How far you can run!
Come on. People are saying that first phase Kaysen had enough HP for a Bloodborne boss fight, and that he even had phase 2, perfect for any Bloodborne boss fight.
I'll squash you like a frog!
Just cause there's no sense in his screams overwhelming my cutting, incisive commentary.
There's no turning back now.
Should probably heal a skosh.
There's no turning back now! You're an annoying little bug! Keep your eyes to the front!
This is tiresome.
Keep your eyes to the front!
I can't say the human hands are supposed to do this.
Heheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheh
There we are.
Emily, I will avenge your death. Just a moment longer. I'll buy you a new dress to make up for all the pain I've caused you. The dress you wore when you came to my hotel room didn't seem to fit you right. Kaysen, I've been meaning to tell you this. You're one crazy guy.
He's holding a figurine of himself, and that is the thing that takes damage. Yeah. I want to make sure I have the audio under control. He really is a monster. Like, you saw what he did. You've probably grasped the implications of what happened to Emily. You saw what he, you know, even did, like, purposely locking this young child into a psychic spiritual prison. You know, for 30 years, like, it's a big deal what's happening right now. Does the presentation just not sell it as anything with gravity?
Forward, 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 forward
Is not doing any damage at all. Nice head, I think I'll take it.
What's this pain?
Just a little bit more.
What's this pain? Are you tired already?
Sorry I'm not responding to chat. I'm, fighting this five-story tall boss.
Why you? Oh, you meddling kids!
What are you doing there, Case? Casey Kasin? Where's he at?
You're an annoying little bug.
Alright. Here we go, let's do some Shadow of the Colossus antics.
What do you think you're doing?
Yeah.
because you don't understand humans. Emily, York tries not to show it, but he's pretty shy. Don't wait for him to propose. Just ask him to marry you.
Cason's phylactery. Well, both York and Emily have moved on. Let's see what this new world looks like. Coffee and Quests says that this enemy design reminds them of Galarians. Well, you're in luck, because Galarians is next. At least the first one, and I've got the second one coming up here as
previously
well.
During the investigation, York, the other me, my other personality.
There are some things in this world that must be extracted, no matter what.
York, I'm sorry, I...
Why can you cause me pain? Red tree!
That's like a liver.
York and Zack. Finally, I understand. You two really are best friends. I'm a little jealous.
I'm sure he'll make you very happy.
Here comes Harry.
Are you leaving today?
Are you leaving today?
Zack, that story I told you the other day, did you believe any of it?
The fact of the matter is that I couldn't save Emily. So it really doesn't matter whether I believed you or not.
I'm very sorry about her. There's something mysterious about that picture. There's a calming beauty to it, and yet it exudes sadness.
Harry, I have a few questions for you.
About what, Zack?
Your last name isn't really Stewart, is it?
Yeah, that is correct. It's really Woodman. Harry Woodman. George was my son.
You were there in the White Room when I was there. Why?
The same reason as your father. Long, long ago, I too was unable to shoot my wife. What's worse is that I was also unable to kill myself. Which is why I lost both. The woman I loved, and my son. My wife suffered from a mental illness, but I still loved her. I wanted to save George too, if I could. Everything was my fault. If only I had the courage to make the right decision, Emily and the other girls would not have died. But you have put an end to all of that.
I wonder if they are happy.
Zack, no need to worry about that. York will guide Emily and the other girls into the forest.
As goddesses of the forest.
Hey, Michael. Mind stopping the car for a moment?
Very well, Mr. Francis Zack Morgan.
I heard you're leaving.
Oh, I forgot that Willie was still alive. Fun fact, Willie was Kaysen's handler.
Uh-huh. That's right.
It's a shame about Emily, and the other girls, too.
How are Isaac and Isaiah?
Oh, they're fine. They still don't think the girls are dead.
Give it to him yourself. He's right next to you.
Oh, okay. I understand. We'll do it for you.
Kaysen was working for the Red Tree.
Emily kind of told us to give this to you.
Emily said it's a present for Zack.
Thank you. Where did you get this?
Emily asked us to give it to you. See? She's over there.
There's another Zack there too. You're twins, just like us.
Emily couldn't give it to you herself. She said she's too embarrassed. So, she asked us to hand it to you.
Emily really likes you, Zack. She really likes you.
No, she doesn't. Not me. She really likes that guy, York. The guy you see standing next to her. Anyways, you two. Be nice to the girls, okay? And they'll be nice to you.
We don't like girls.
Girls are boring.
Gotta love them. Just full of energy.
Emily, York, sounds like you're both doing fine. I feel better about you two now. And hey, York,
figured out why George carried on his body all the way into the woods.
It was for them. He wanted Isaac and Isaiah to find her.
Mr. Francis Zach Morgan, if you are finished, if you are, please, let us return to the car.
No need for that. You can go home. I want to take a look around more.
Very well, then. I'm sure Mr. Stewart will approve of that.
Ah, thank you, Michael.
So, yeah. York is happy with Emily. Continuing what I was saying before, if I'm not interrupted again. Kaysen was working for the Red Tree, this eldritch monstrosity. Meanwhile, Willie, that Dalmatian dog that we found, well, he was assigned to watch him. At least, that is according to Swery61, creator of this game. It doesn't impact a whole lot, but yeah, Willie is still here to continue sowing madness, and well, Willie took out the Red Tree's most apparent co-conspirator. And we're headed out of town. Back to the FBI, possibly. So, some more details about this. York, the person we've been playing as, was really only the most apparent version of Zach. Everybody else has seen Zach as he was with the scar that Kaysen gave him. But everybody else has heard about him as Francis Zach Morgan. That's why Emily knew him as Zach and why Michael referred to him as Francis Zach Morgan. York was kind of the person acting as the interlocutor. There we go. Let's see what Zach has to say.
York, can you hear me? I'm a little jealous.
I'm all alone on this side now.
But don't worry, York.
I've had it easy for so long having you with me. I need to get used to being on my own.
But yeah, they were twins, and York was the one who stepped in, was created after Zach was kind of forced into the Red Room to help them still function. And York was, you know, referring to Zach. We all kind of thought that Zach was the character, right? The player. But no, Zach was the person that York was relaying the information to. York was just kind of inhabiting his body for a little bit. Now, I could go here in the 26th or 27th chapter and do some side quests, and everybody would respond to me as Zach and give a little bit of kind of their own commentary on the version of events that that happened, but I'm really only here to do the main stuff. So I'm gonna head to the road out of town. I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I missed in terms of kind of the masterminds behind this and the esoteric lore. This chapter only ends when you go to the marker over there. Does anybody have any questions in the chat? I don't know everything about this game. I've read about it probably as much as anybody who really cares about it.
One more thing, York. I hope things are going well with Emily.
You've always been horrible with women. I gave you tons of advice during your last relationship, and you ignored all of it. I'm sure Emily will take the lead. Just don't fight her. Let her steer you in the right direction.
Jeremy says that everything in this game seems like it takes four times as long as it should. Yeah, you're right. It's kind of a bummer. You know, it really is kind of an act of affection for the very weirdness that this game puts forward. That anybody is able to finish it at all, especially look at it. Like, I would not blame anybody for not wanting to go through this themselves.
York, tonight I'm going to sleep like a baby. Zach, it's over. All finished. It's time for you to leave town. Are you ready to go? Then this is goodbye, Zach. Thank you for everything. Good night, Zach. And sleep tight.
There's Kaysen. It's a shining reveal.
Polly, what's that picture?
Oh, that. We took it when the clock tower was built.
50 years ago?
That's right. That's me in the middle. I was pretty popular back then. Men were always around me. Sorry to keep you waiting. Just sign here, please. Mr. Morgan? Mr. Morgan!
Oh, I'm sorry, Polly. I was just thinking of a friend. Someone who was with me for a long, long time.
He must have been a really good friend, then. Otherwise, why else would you remember him at a time like this?
Indeed. We used to fight, but he really was a good person. He's gone now, though. Gone away to a place where we can't meet again.
I'm sorry to hear that, but if he's a friend of yours, I'm sure he's getting on just fine.
Thank you, Polly. You know what? I think so too.
And York is left in Greenvale. But Zach doesn't smoke.
Did Emily die?
No. She became the goddess of the forest. Even now, she is still in the forest with York. She watches over the world from there.
Emily became a goddess.
That's right. Isn't that a lovely ending?
Hey, Grandpa, can I ask you something? What kind of person is York?
York? He's a real nice guy. He's been a good friend of mine since I was small.
Like Mr. Teddy?
Yes, just like Mr. Teddy. A very important friend.
So yeah.
Emily!
Oh wait.
It's almost time for dinner. Take your grandfather's dinner up to him, will you?
Yes, Mom.
I'm afraid to talk because
How's your grandfather doing?
I don't know. He's calling me Emily again.
Oh dear, he must be losing his memory. You are Louise, honey. Michelle Louise Morgan. Not Emily. You know that, right?
I know my own name, Mom.
I know you do, baby. You're just so lovely, Louise. I'm sure that's why your grandfather mixes you up with a goddess.
Yeah. I like this game a lot. I mean, I've had a lot of frustrations going back through it. And...
Mom, where is the goddess?
I don't know, dear. I'm not much like your grandfather.
Is there even such a thing as a goddess?
I believe so, but I've never met one.
Mom, you're so pretty. You look like a goddess.
Oh, thank you, honey. If I am a goddess, then you are an angel.
Yeah, but I still have so much affection for this. I don't know, like, it pushes so many of my buttons. Not just the David Lynch stuff, but just the survival horror things. Let me turn down this volume a little bit. Oh, man. Just the collision of half-baked systems. I don't know. Like, for as incomplete as it feels pretty complete for as... You know, much in my mind as I think this is a fully baked thing. It really is half baked, but like, I don't know, the flavor makes up for so much of it. I'm very happy that they recognized what kind of mechanical problems there were with the Xbox version, and then gave us this remix that we have on the PlayStation 3 and the PC. I really think that it does play better, but you still have stuff like the endless driving sections and the even more endless wall crawler enemies. But still, I don't know, this is kind of one of those things that it's okay if you don't like it. I'm still going to just talk so much sugar about it. I'll be right back while these credits go, because there's a post-credits thing. One second. And I'm back. Thank you for brooking
Mom,
that 20 second.
Can you believe
oh, there we go.
That Grandpa tells?
You believe them, Louise? They're all just made up stories, dear. All fiction. Like your picture books.
So all my picture book stories aren't true?
Oh, don't twist things around, Louise. You just want to know everything, don't you? Here, take this dinner to your grandfather. Go on while it's still hot.
Mom, I understand what Grandpa's talking about. I've got Mr. Teddy, just like Grandpa's York.
Very nice, dear. Now off you go. Hold it straight or you'll spill the soup.
I've got it.
I really am afraid to talk because I don't know when I'm going to be interrupted. There's going to be a small little sequel hook twist here in a minute. That was Deadly Premonition. It's a game I pretty much always take every opportunity to say positive things about. But people who watched and listened know, it's got problems. I've sworn so much just about the crazy bad decisions that the designers of this game made. But almost none of it has to do with the flavor. And, It is a wonderful flavor that they put forward for this. There's Anna. Gets to be with Emily. He got to have his dinner with her at the diner after all. Zach at the end of it all, or maybe
see you again. How many years has it been?
I've been close to you the whole time. You probably couldn't see me, but you felt my presence nearby, right, Zach? I never thought you'd get married and have a family. Quite a surprise. I spent years honing my profiling skills, but I never saw that one coming. That's what makes humans so interesting. And that's why I just can't leave you guys alone. More than anything else. Seeing you look so happy is the best thing I could ever ask for. Anyway, Zach, did you see the newspaper today? As it turns out, over the last 3 months, there's been a string of bizarre incidents near New Orleans. Residents there are reporting a sudden strike of nausea, and then they completely lose control of their bodies. Some have already had 2 months of only being able to walk backwards. Does that make you feel anything? It makes me feel something. I know you feel it too, Zach. Okay, Zach. I thought that's what you'd say. Well then, it's time to wake up, Zach.
So when do we leave? Yeah, so thank you so much, everybody, for watching me play what is, like, honestly one of my favorite games. And if you take exception to the, you know, whole this game being good part, one of my favorite pieces of media. Like, this is, man, I can't think of anything else like it. So, oh, man. So I've got to spend the next couple weeks, so I'm going to be getting ready to go on vacation here. And then I'm going to be on vacation, and then I'm going to be in Austin, Texas. I don't think I'm going to be able to stream until August. It wouldn't be wise for me to stream until August, as it were. So, yeah, sorry I'm going to be away for so long, but yeah, just the way it's got to be. Watch at Cole Ross for vacation picks. Watch at Hexcrank for announcements of when the next streaming series is going to begin. I'm going to be doing Galarians for the PlayStation 1. I already have it. I was reading the manual in bed last night, if you'll believe it. Boy, I've got just so much more happening here. If you missed any portion of this, go to youtube.com/duckfeedtv to see the archives of these streams. And yeah, I just really appreciate everybody who has taken the time to watch and participate in chat and do everything you've done. So take care. Have a wonderful weekend. And I will see you again. Well, not real soon, but soon enough. Bye.